I thought you were going to say hand jobs, and I was very concerned.
That too.
Where's your mind at?
It's clear to see where Ray's mind jumps to.
Alright.
Oh, I think I did too much.
That's the only reason to be a guardian.
For the hand jobs? Hand jobs.
That's so what that back is for.
Distribution, you didn't tell us that there were perks to the job.
Need to know basis, my friend. And you don't need to know.
We've already said too much.
Podcast number 45. I am Dark Ones Ray, and here with us today we have a stellar cast. We actually have
super cast.
Tijin Lee, I'm looking at you.
Hi.
We have Tijin Lee.
Yes. I'm first.
We also have with us Nobod.
Hey.
We have Lozelda.
What's up, bitches?
Well.
Wubwave.
Making my monthly appearance.
Mr. Fusion. Nice.
Sexy. Uh-huh.
Chaos Mana.
Hello.
And, of course, the Blabbermouth Ray.
Six.
We have to provide a disclaimer that Ray's had a few drinks in her already, so chances
are... Well, she's
are
already out of vodka.
She's at level volatile right now, so we don't, she's unpredictable, folks.
I like how Ray having drinks warrants a disclaimer, but me having drinks does not. I don't know what that says about me, but
Well,
you're not a big enough asshole when you're drunk.
Oh, I need to try harder.
Challenging. That was a very nice backhanded compliment.
Oh, gosh. And I know I said earlier today on Rooster Teeth that this podcast was at 50% less Hitler. And Ray, I'm looking
that
at...
That still leaves a lot of Hitler, according to Lozo.
Your new icon, and she has the... You can't see it, but she has the Nyan cat.
Nyan cat.
Pop-Tart. Man. She's got the Nazi flag, and the little cat has a Hitler stash.
Oh my god, are you serious?
That doesn't shoot you off on me.
I have to go look.
Not to mention the haircut.
Mine cat.
So thank you, Ray, for already going over our 50% limit of
wait,
Hitler.
Wait, how does that make it 50%?
Wait.
It all depends on how much Hitler we talk about during this podcast.
Well,
so
no,
that
no,
might have
no,
just been 100%.
We're currently at 100%, by the way.
Because technically it's half of that and half of the cat. It's not like a full picture.
We just have to compare it to how much Hitler we talked about last week and do less.
Yeah, I got really drunk by that point in time, so I don't really remember how much we talked about.
Well, Zelda is the one that said that 50% is too much. What is an acceptable level of Hitler?
No, I just said still that's still a lot of fuck words.
How many times do you hear that phrase?
That is too much Hitler. That is a name that should become like a comedian. It just should become in the public domain just a joke. We need to turn Hitler into a joke.
Is it not?
It hasn't reached that level yet.
There's an entire website dedicated to cats that look like Hitler. I think we've reached the point.
Yeah, there's the epic rap battles of Darth Vader versus Hitler.
It's not enough, though. It's not enough.
What is enough? At what point are there enough?
You mean all the parodies of the Hitler movie where they just say he's getting upset about whatever, and I think that's enough to discredit Hitler. His image.
Do we have enough Onion articles referencing Hitler?
And enough video games. I mean, God, how many times is Hitler the main bad guy in video games?
Wolfenstein.
Oh, speaking of, do you remember Bionic Commando, the old NES version?
Oh, Bionic Commando. They did a remake
yeah,
like
bad.
For the Xbox. No, it was the 2D remake, not the 3D remake.
Okay, the 3D was really good.
The 2D remake was really cool. It was like the same game, only with shiny.
But do you remember the final boss was a juiced up, muscle bound Hitler?
Oh my god, I remember that game now.
He did have a really freaky looking stash, didn't he?
What was the one where you like the end boss was the Hitler in like a robot suit at first, and then you had to fight.
Played it on the gauntlet.
Yeah, that one. What would not?
Wolfenstein.
It's like the ultimate steampunk enemy. Hitler.
Wasn't it Wolfenstein?
I think it's that.
Ooh, yes, I think that's it.
That was Wolfenstein. Yeah.
Someone did anybody play that?
I already said
no, I'm only 21 years old, dude.
I'm only 25. Can I say something about Bionic Commando?
I want to say something about Bionic Commando. Something cool about that game was how like they had like that new like how like his arm was like a grappling hook. And then you use it like a grappling hook throughout the games. I just thought that was really cool because it was like new to everything that I was playing prior.
Totally cool, man.
And then like Earthworm Jim and Tomb Raider came out, but you know, it was different.
Nobod, what is your profile pic?
Hey, that is
always changing.
That one picture
is different. That is what it is.
Yeah, why is your face on a bunch of screens, and was that Photoshopped?
That was not Photoshopped. That I'm actually.
What was it?
I don't remember. I found that randomly in my
library. It looks like a Photoshop.
I think it's
I don't have Photoshop.
What's that program called? It's the thing what? That you can. It's like you know when you do webcam stuff and you like make it all
the
swirly.
CyberLink UCam, and then like in CyberLink UCam there is a setting with that, and yeah, that's what it is. Like, you just do that, and the picture will come up like that.
Who's dying?
Oh my God.
Nobody's dad is dying in the background.
Yeah, all right. Over
sorry.
There.
What are we gonna feature your dad?
We feature him every time Nobody's on.
Every time I'm here.
I feel like we should have a fan group for him, just like we have a fan group for Ken.
He's not up to Ken's level. Excuse you.
Yeah, Ken still has yet to even. I want him to just like about to say a phrase or say like a small thing and then get cut off at the end because that's the end of the podcast. Like, he'll start to say a sentence. Something random like that.
Like Barry does? Hi.
There's a good probability that could potentially happen.
Say hi to our fans, Ken. Hi. And then everyone screams, oh my god! Yeah,
because
Game Grumps did not do that. Game Grumps never did that.
Yes, go ahead.
I received terrific news today.
What news is that?
This news that I received is that...
It's not herpes.
No, that would clean. Be bad news.
It's just a rash.
Yeah, that would be bad news because then he's still undiagnosed. That's
true. My bad. Okay. Sorry. Continue.
Okay. Go ahead.
Twice again, clean. This good news.
This region in North Carolina that I live in, the Research Triangle, is being considered for Google Fiber.
What?
No.
Yes.
Damn you.
It could happen as soon as the end of the year.
Wow, I didn't. That's crazy.
Dark if you're looking for a roommate.
I don't really think it's going to happen that soon, but that's the earliest prediction. They're trying to make it happen, and I'm super excited about it now.
Oh, fuck.
I'm stuck on my neighbor's Wi-Fi.
What was that, Nobod? Or Nobod, Webwave? Were you bitching again?
Probably. I said I'm stuck on my neighbor's Wi-Fi, and you're getting Google Fiber. There's like no
get your own Wi-Fi injustice. You loader.
Yeah. Whose Wi-Fi are you stealing, Nobod?
Nah.
Same one.
My neighbor?
That's why he's going slow.
Well, that explains why there's lag.
Yeah.
Okay, so maybe we can make this announcement. We're going to be doing the podcast from RTX this year for sure now.
Oh, what?
We are for sure.
Congrats.
Oh. No. I did say the panel. The panel still, no.
Okay, I was going to say, I only started filling that
no. No, last year we were not able to do the podcast because we could secure a location where we'll all be, but...
Right, but we do have a location now.
We have a location.
Hang out with us, Fusion. We wanted to hang out with you. You wouldn't hang out.
What's that?
You wouldn't hang out with us.
There was a little more to it than that. I made the mistake of volunteering for night events too.
You volunteered because you didn't want to see us because you're just stuck up right.
Yeah. Okay, guys. A confession here. I don't like any of you at all. I can't stand you all. I wish you would all die in a fire. That's pretty much it.
All right. We'll get right on that. As long as you all get to die first, I'm okay.
So no, seriously, some of us are all going to be bunking in the same hotel. The plan A fell through, unfortunately. Dark and I made a very strong push, and it just was not working. So,
which is ridiculous. This is months in advance. It doesn't make any sense.
I mean, I could go ahead and be an asshole about it. In the past, years ago, I used to use HomeAway.com a lot for road trips. We would stay, my wife and I and our two little dogs,
HomeAway.
We would stay at a lot of houses because it was easier than a hotel when we had our dogs with us. So I used them for years, but you know, the last couple of years they've changed their site and how they handle policies with renters. And we basically had a nightmare. We had two condos set up around the corner from the convention center, and other people jumped on that, which that's fine. I'm not going to complain about them, but the owners of the property did not tell me what was going on. And as we were getting the deposits together to get the paperwork started, they didn't even tell me, and they just took them off the site, and I had to bug them to find out if they were gone. So that happened, and then we found another location, which was about a mile from downtown, which was still a very nice house.
Yeah, absolutely, still doable.
But they were screwing us over because they kept changing the amounts after we showed interest in the property. So by that point, we just threw our hands up and said, fuck this, we're just going to do the hotel thing.
The icing on the cake was when I was trying to do that part. And the icing on the cake was when they finally replied back to me and they sent me the contract to sign that was a read-only version. So they're like, yeah, you need to print that out and mail it back to us. And you need to supply a photo or photocopy of your driver's license and credit card.
Yeah.
And I'm like, excuse me? I am not about to mail that shit to you.
And see, in the past with HomeAway, you could use your credit card, you could use PayPal, and you would just take care of that all online or on the phone. You didn't have to give them make copies of these things to send to them. And we just got frustrated because they kept changing everything up.
Shady.
So
yeah, you'd think that'd be pretty standard to just use the fucking internet.
Yeah, like the same way you would like reserve a hotel room or purchase tickets or something. Just you do it online and you get a confirmation number and then it's done.
Didn't they also tell you that we had to pay in full as well?
They did. Yeah, that's right. They did. Like first we were told that there would just be a deposit.
And then
when they sent me the contract, they're like, no, we're not doing the deposit anymore. You need to pay in full 7 days after the contract is signed. No, that was just the wording of the contract itself. I actually read it. And I'm like, what is this shit? Bad. Really, really bad business model. Do not do business with them. They're assholes.
Yeah.
You have to pledge your firstborn child.
Pretty much. I mean, on the website it says one thing, and then, you know, when you on the website they have a rate. But of course, they have holiday rates, and also they say rates may change based on, you know, what dates you want. So we would send them emails, and I would send the condo owners emails, and they would tell me the rates were completely different. You know, it was just getting ridiculous. And then when we got screwed over on the condos, it's like, okay, let's try the house. Found the house, and then Dark was like, okay, they're telling me this and this and this and this. This is getting ridiculous. So we said, screw that. So we booked right across the street at the Hilton.
So anybody else that's like thinking of doing something similar to this went for RTX this year, just be forewarned.
Yeah.
Like they will screw you over. Just be careful and be smart about it.
And I'll go ahead and throw one out there. There is a property on 6th Street that's very cheap. It's like $140 a night. And you're going to see it. It's a decent-sized condo. I found out from asking a few people. Well, I have a friend that used to work for HomeAway in the Austin office, and she looked into it for me. And apparently this property is on 6th Street. It's in a building where there's a nightclub. And pretty much throughout the entire night, you just hear
I love it.
So
it's like a thin white noise machine.
Exactly. So it's kind of a bad place to stay if you're trying to get.
What's wrong with instance?
Yeah, as long as you have enough, you just get a box fan, turn it on high, and then it all just kind of blends into one giant blur of white.
Or you can just keep this podcast on loop and just listen to us all night.
Just dance.
Yeah, who
we're mixed?
Wow, is such a salesman, man. I appreciate that.
Nice segue.
Yeah.
You're our what do you call it? What do you call someone who we don't pay you? So you're not a whore. So you're kind of like a slut.
You're an intern.
A groupie.
There we go. That Wait, sounds what? Better than slut.
He's the TFT groupie.
Who?
TJ.
Were you?
Oh, sorry. You're not a member anymore.
No, I am paying attention. I just couldn't.
Do I get college credit for this?
No, you don't.
Damn it! Why am I here?
Pass, fail, and you failed.
I'm your favorite. Yes.
Of course.
She's also had a few drinks. So you have to take that.
That's good. Call.
That,
yeah. Everyone's her favorite when she drinks, so don't take it personally.
Not really. He's my favorite.
Except me.
How does that make any sense?
Well, Dungeons and Dragons gay, so obviously.
Well, you know what? I'm pretty upset that you called Dungeons and Dragons gay.
Well, and I'm sorry if I offended you because I love you.
Excellent.
But I take it back.
Such double standards.
Yeah. Welcome to life.
So, I forgot the name of this game that I've already had too much to drink. I had kind of a shitty afternoon at work, so I decided to start drinking right away. There's this game with giant robots.
Titanfall.
Titanfall. Yes. Has anybody?
Everybody's obsessed with this game.
Has anybody played it yet? Done the beta or anything?
Giant robots. I thought they were titans.
Does it sound like anyone else played it?
I did not play it. No.
I came home and was watching a video about it.
Let's all pretend to talk, like, know what we're talking about.
I do know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, that one thing happened, that one guy, and it was awesome.
And then there was the stuff.
Aliens.
Remember the stuff.
And Big Bada Boom.
And then they blew up Megaton.
And then they flew to the moon.
Wait, when did Optimus die? Wasn't that in there somewhere, too?
Oh, I'm still traumatized from when Optimus died.
Yeah. Fusion, you're not wrong. It's like it was like it.
Buy more vodka. I will.
Okay. I was.
You're a damn thing you're saying.
I know.
My cousin gave me the VHS of the movie, and I'm just like, oh, Transform was awesome. Oh, you can't.
Well, see, I was like 6 when that movie came out.
Yeah.
Okay. And imagine 6-year-old me. A huge Optimus was my favorite character, and I'm watching the movie in the theater, and he dies. I was fucking traumatized. I was.
You cried, didn't you?
I cried. I didn't cry my eyes out, but I cried. It was sad.
Be honest, you cried like a little bitch.
I still cry like a little bitch when I watch it.
You are a little bitch.
You're not wrong. You're not wrong.
It's sad. It's Optimus. Now, the Michael Bay Optimus, I don't feel so bad when he dies, because, you know, he's a bit of a pussy.
Wait, when did he die?
The second movie?
He died in the second movie? I don't remember that.
He died, but then he undied, so it's fine.
The cartoon movie or the...
No, the Michael Bay Optimus is a...
I don't remember much about the second Michael Bay Transformers movie. I like to pretend like it never happened.
That's exactly. What a lot of people...
Apparently there was a third.
There was a third. It was actually better than the second.
What? No,
the third was the worst. I disagree.
I thought it was better than the second. I thought the second one was so bad that... Like, it was that thing that just couldn't possibly get any worse, and so just by comparison, the third one was better just because.
See, that's the thing, is I agree with you to a point where the second one, you're like, oh man, it can't get any worse than this, and then the third one came out, and you went, I stand corrected.
Well, the only thing the third one has going for it is the awesome, like, siege of the city there at the end. Like, that was pretty fun to watch. I had a good time.
The third Transformers invalidates the first two movies. It invalidates them.
I'm okay with it invalidating the second movie.
But I'm talking about the plots for the first two are completely thrown out of the window on the plot. Okay, well, Sentinel Prime was in a ship on the way from Cybertron to Earth to unleash the pillars, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I couldn't really follow that because the whole Dark of the Moon thing just kind of defied the laws of science anyway. So I just decided to suspend disbelief and just go.
When Michael Bay is involved, you have to stop thinking about science or anything else that makes sense.
Exactly. Think like a short buzzer would.
I'm really interested in how that explosion works.
Pretty robots.
Well, anyway, so let me just real quick, and I'll let everybody out, and I'll shut up. But this is what really drove me crazy. he was on his way to Earth to unleash the pillars to bring Cybertron to this side of the universe or the galaxy. Okay, but yeah. He was in cahoots with Megatron the whole time. So why the fuck didn't he just come to Earth to get the Allspark if he and Megatron knew, well, if Megatron knew the Allspark was on Earth, why didn't they just work together to get here to get the Allspark rather than bringing the unleashing the pillars?
That invalidates. Super easy. I can tell you why.
Why?
Because they had bad writers.
At the same time, these guys are not like perfect. They might have, it's just oops. They just didn't think of that.
Well, I mean, no, when you're making a $300 million movie, at least pay one guy $40,000 to kind of fill those holes in, you know? That's his job is to fucking fill all the holes of these movies.
They knew that it didn't matter how ridiculous the plot was, that's people would go and watch the movie anyway.
Michael Bay does not give a
shit. It's transforming robots, dude.
Okay. Now, for the
second nostalgia in a can.
For the second movie, the Fallen is hanging out on the moon, right?
That's right.
We saw that one.
Okay. Well, did Sentinel Prime know that the Fallen was hanging out on the moon? Because Megatron did.
Obviously not. He's really stupid.
Yeah,
they're giant computers. How can they not detect one another?
What was it with those two racist robots?
They're racist.
The amazing robots.
That's their entire character. Racist.
The best robots.
How could they be?
They're like
one of them had a gold tooth. Come on, seriously.
Yeah.
It was awesome. They were my favorite thing.
So here's the issue I have with the quote-unquote racist robots.
Now we know why Ray has.
We're sitting there, we're saying like, oh, they have gold teeth and they're talking the way that they talk, and that makes them racist.
It means that they're black.
Isn't that just us stereotyping?
Exactly.
Michael Bay trolled all of us. That was his goal. Because his argument is, aren't you being racist by pointing that out?
Exactly. It's like, we're the racist now. Like, oh, they sound like this. They must be making fun of black people. It's like, kind of race other than we heard them talk away and we went, oh, this.
Yeah.
Aside from the fact that they were a pitch perfect pigeonhole of stereotypes from almost 20 years ago.
Yeah, but so is jazz. I mean,
why did robots have teeth?
What?
Well, yeah, there's that problem.
That's why you're questioning they're alive. Why do robots have teeth?
Because they need to appear humanoid on Earth.
Oh my god!
No, they don't.
They don't need to. They don't need to. They turn into cars.
No. Yeah, they're cars.
I need to reevaluate my life. Why do robots have teeth?
They're not just cars per se. They're electronic devices.
I mean, if you're gonna ask why they have teeth, why did Devastator have a big pair of balls? Was that necessary? You know,
I was okay
because he wanted to show his.
That made me so happy.
You were symbolism. You were happy to see Transformer testicles.
Who's the Transformer that turns to the radio?
Wheelie. No.
The little one. The little Decepticon. That has,
Wheelie.
There's one that turns into a radio, and then there's one that turns into like a tape. And then the tape would go
that's Soundwave. That's Soundwave, and that's Rumble.
Ravage and Laserbeak and...
We got him?
Rumble? Oh, yeah, that's right.
So let's forget all about this nonsense, and let's talk about how...
Let's talk about Beast Wars, and that was the better Transformers.
Yes!
I
was going to say let's talk about the Dinobots in the next movie, but Beast Wars...
I love the Dinobots the best.
Well, you got to admit, when that first Super Bowl trailer came out, everyone's like, fuck, another Transformers movie. Then you saw Grimlock, you're like, fuck it, it's Grimlock, I'm going.
You just think that's Grimlock, the reason everybody wants to go?
Fuck yeah!
Yeah.
Grimlock is the king, dude.
Yes.
I mean, he says so all the time.
What's there to not get? You must go see this movie.
The studio said you need to release another Transformers movie. He's like, I don't want to fucking do this. We'll pay you $400 million. Okay, well, what can I do? Fuck it, Dinobots. That's all he has to say, Dinobots. He could have released a press release that just said, fuck it, Dinobots. That's $500 million right there. That's all you have to do. Everyone loves the Dinobots.
I'm gonna get a ticket just because. Dinobots.
I'm going to make a t-shirt that just says, fuck it, Dinobots.
That could be our first...
I'm only here for Dinobots. You're paying the same amount of money.
No, you don't have to say I'm here for it. Just say, fuck it, period. Dinobots.
Jen Lee, get on designing the art for that.
Okay.
That's your new job. Drop everything you're doing. Right now. And
such is my life.
Dinobots
is you know how to do art. Can you make me a t-shirt? Nope.
I'm having an argument with Dinobot in the chat. This must sound really weird. He's typing, I'm speaking.
Well, why don't you just drink the wine?
I could put
I'm trying to get rid of it.
I could put the Skype chat on the feed so everyone would just see it anyway.
No! Do it.
You really should. Yeah. Because I keep on hearing the little boop boop noise in my ear, and it used to annoy me, but now I just kind of tune it out.
My mom brought me wine since we were out of vodka. She's like, you want me to bring it? I'm like, fine, I'll chug it. It's really gross.
Just tell your mom it. I said come hi.
On. Do it for the podcast.
A sassy apple says, I want that t-shirt right meow.
Oh, fuck, sassy apple. I think that's my sister. Hi.
Sassy apple. Hi, sassy apple.
I wish I could post this on Facebook.
No, fuck it. Dinobots.
Swear to God, if you have this on where mom and dad can hear it, I'm going to kill you.
My mom would love this.
Hello, Zelda's mom and dad.
Zelda fans. My mom loves your biggest fans.
How old are you, Lo Zelda?
It sounds Dark, like, it sounds like your sister would be related to, it's like the annoying orange or the sassy apple.
Yeah, she's definitely, imagine this. She's the sassy one between the two of us. And you've talked to me.
That's a lot of sass.
I know, right?
So are you
that is like Hitler sass. Level of sass.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Now we've gone from
is
having
it my level of sass?
No.
It's
no,
your
no.
level of drunk sass.
Drunk sass. Much different from regular sass.
Some I sass really think or ass. Dinobots needs to be a shirt.
Dinobots is a trademark.
I would wear it. I would so wear that.
Dinobots is a trademark. My mistake.
So I'll do TFT podcast t-shirt on the back. Fuck it, Dinobots.
That's what we can do, yes. We can have merchandise, official merchandise.
That's how we're going to get people to come to the panel. We offer them free
I need
t-shirts.
A house, but I didn't make a door.
Well, you know, help pay for the website.
How are we Wait, ever going to choose a Minecraft? Thumbnail?
The thumbnail is going to be just... The thumbnail is going to be a Dinobot. Fusion.
Nine cat. It should be nine cat.
If it's like the fusion, it's going to end up being
nine cat. Nine cat.
Shut up, Ray.
It's not going to be nine cat.
Ray,
I
should have
been playing.
I always think it said like you would say.
Nine cat will be the intro to this podcast, probably.
Okay, thank you.
The best part of live podcast is we can cut Ray off at some point.
Oh.
He
won't do it. David won't do it.
All right, we're shutting off.
Wait, who's hosting this call?
Fusion. I meant from alcohol. I meant from alcohol. I meant from alcohol.
It's okay. I don't want any more wines. Gross.
I can throw down the Zach hammer at any time.
The Zach hammer.
Come at me, bro.
Come at me, bro.
Don't threaten
me. I love you, Fusion! No!
See, he doesn't come at you. He just makes you go away.
I love you so much.
It's all my games. I just don't say anything to her and she just begs
for mercy. I'll be quiet.
The range of emotions that Ray can go through in
I know, that
short
was pretty,
period of time.
That was trippy, wasn't it? She went from fuck you to I love you. Fucking dickhead.
Welcome to David's life. Hey,
dog. We're boys.
Yeah, that's classic.
Because you're a dick.
I need coal. Okay, there we go.
I think
just gonna ignore this.
I think Chaos is learning a lot from this podcast.
Chaos
He's learned what
to
say and what not to say. I've taught him well. We're not even married, and I've taught him so well. He's just gonna be quiet and sit over there.
You know what, Ray? There's a secret marriage. We men develop this tone deafness, and it's very effective for us.
He does not ignore me. He knows
selective hearing.
Don't share our secrets.
Almost
50% of this podcast. I know what that is.
You're asexual, dude. Don't even. What's this wee crap?
David wouldn't.
You don't know.
He knows
me.
Who is doing that annoying shit?
If he wants the wedding night to happen, he will not ignore me.
Oh.
He's a very.
This is really early to be starting those kind of threats.
Yeah.
I'd be worried.
Is it really early? I don't think it's early.
Yeah, we're going.
Yeah, you're playing your
going through the whole marriage thing. We met last April. It's already happening.
Don't worry, dude. In about 2 minutes, she'll change that threat. She'll be like,
I've done enough to him to make him want the wedding night, so he'll shut up.
Okay, wow. Yeah, we're going.
Just don't listen to me.
So, Dave, just don't speak for the next 7 months, and you might survive.
Exactly.
Best deal you're gonna get.
He knows to be quiet. Have you heard him speak this whole time?
Yeah.
He said something about coal.
He's entertaining
he something about
the
coal thumbnail.
How is he?
Hey,
you are crazy.
He's a good little boy.
Little boy.
Hey. I take that back.
How tall are you, Dark?
Is that what you mean by little, David? I look at my face.
You could have just let that go, Ray. Come on.
Why are we changing? Why are we changing the subject here? We're not talking about me.
He's so innocent. I love it.
Let's talk about height.
I've ruined it. It's gone now. The innocence.
No.
Gone.
I have something better to talk about. Lozelda.
Yes.
What was your most recent video that you've done a Let's Play on?
Still doing Fez.
So why haven't you beaten Fez yet?
Because I'm retarded. So the drinking level.
We don't want to watch you suck at Fez. We want to watch you be really good at Fez.
Well, you know what?
Isn't that when you watch some video gamers? Not because they'll just do an instant perfect playthrough. It's because they'll fail at doing the playthrough.
Exactly. I watch because
I want to know how to win it.
You are watching the wrong fucking
channel. That's right. I have a policy. I don't want to hear about anybody's 10K unless they want it.
Ooh.
And I have way too many people talking about their 5 and 10Ks.
Ooh. Someone just needs to bring the ban hammer on Tejin Lee here. He's gotten a little too much attitude for this podcast.
No, is Zach on the podcast?
Alone. I love him.
Is Zach in the chat?
Zach can ban me.
No. Zach, don't do it.
Zach is not in the chat.
Zach, I love him.
If Zach's ever on our podcast, can we actually make him host the call so that he can?
He won't do it, though. He likes to talk before I do David.
Let's just talk about Zach. Zach's nice.
We can give him Zach the power to do it during a live panel.
I like that.
Have him kick out people.
We can have whoever the guardians are.
That's a lot of... Rainbow Avenger! Rainbow Avenger!
Give them all hammers.
I thought you were going to say hand jobs, and I was very concerned.
It's clear to see where Ray's mind jumps to.
Alright.
Oh, I think I did too much.
That's the only reason to be a guardian.
For the hand jobs? That's what that back is for. Mr. Fusion, you didn't tell us that there were perks to the job.
Need to know basis, my friend. And you don't need to know.
We've already said too much.
Yes.
Time for the diddling, Lozelda.
The diddling.
Lozelda, you knew too?
I volunteer myself as tribute.
That could be taken way too many different ways, and none of them are good.
Yeah.
I know. You know how I meant it, so I'll just let it be. You know exactly what I meant.
Oh, we know what you meant.
I have no idea. Please share.
Shut up.
No, bud. Just get on the internet and do a Google search.
Look up
safe search turned off. And
yeah, dude. Just Google image search tea party. I mean, a lemon party. And
that's it.
There you go. Lemon party.
Oh goodness.
I prefer.
Wub, you want to start your own podcast, eh?
Wub. Do you not love us, Wub? Is that why you want to start your own?
Why wait, wasn't that my question to you that started this podcast?
Probably.
I think it was that. I think it was.
And now you're going to try and take credit for the podcast?
Yeah, no. You've tried to say that before.
No.
It was more of a collection
see you,
of
asshole.
Me and Dark. And
you son of a bitch.
I was there too.
I was saying it was the original, you know, four on the first one. It was more of us like talking back and forth. It wasn't like you and Webwave only.
Race it down. Go home, Ray. You're drunk. I am home. I don't understand. I'm sitting down.
You're not supposed to actually read the chat. It's not how it works. The chat is supposed to be
private.
Yeah, you're
breaking fourth wall.
This is the fifth wall. The fifth wall is the TFT chat. Don't talk about it.
Chat, like, as a separate window on top of the Minecraft.
We need some privacy.
You don't
want to
complicate things for listeners.
That's secret stuff that only we...
Yeah, there's already 8 conversations going on at once. They don't need, like, a 7.
Yeah. They already have the random Minecraft chat that's just...
We're kind of all over the place. So.
Yeah, is anybody listening to this
Skype
now?
Chat.
Has anyone been there? Is anyone watching us?
Well, there's 8 people. There's 8 people.
Well,
probably
just us. Our entire Twitch
chat.
Okay, guys. Yes. So they can know what we're talking about with the Skype chat. From what I can see, the comments that we currently have, we have What? And why you do this? Then the wine is gone. Then, hey, Chaos, want to start our own podcast? Then, F you, Wubs. Then, Ray, sit down. And then, go home, Ray. You're drunk. So this is the type of stuff that happens in our Skype chat during the podcast.
We have a secret chat. Now that they know about it, it's not secret anymore.
Well, this doesn't normally happen, because I normally don't do this.
Uh-huh. That's what all sluts.
Oh.
Whoa! Whoa!
Why is he still a virgin?
Oh.
Oh, shit. All right.
This is going too far.
Yeah, we're going down a weird road. Getting a little uncomfortable here.
Hey, you know, we've already gone down the weird road, and we're starting to hit the off-road bumpy. We're not even on a road anymore. We can't even call it a road.
So now it's just getting weird.
We're lost in the weird.
In the chat, we have Nobod adding, "I'm a sexual caterpillar."
What does that mean? First of all, I'd like to point out, I'm really bothered by the fact that caterpillar is not spelled correctly.
No, that's what he does. That
and then sexual has two X's in it, but caterpillar is what's really throwing me off.
Sexual caterpillar.
Sexual.
That is a perfect thing for Nobod, Knucklehead, or Nilo.
Speaking of...
Do you have a game lined up for us? Oh, you are my hero tonight, Mr. Fusion.
Okay, let me write down everything.
Was that just set up? What? That was smooth.
No, go ahead. Talk amongst yourselves.
All kinds of smooth right now.
Rabble.
So, amongst yourselves, how is it?
Conversation. Weather.
That was weather, right?
What the hell?
It's warm. Changingly. How about our weather?
The weather is being unfair to Texas.
The weather is terrible.
Guys, my door to my little sister's room is shut, and her cat somehow got in my room, and I'm very concerned and confused.
Okay, I have a solution. Let's fill the house with pesticides.
Okay,
describe
to us completely in detail what this cat is
doing.
That was good, Zelda.
This is a dream.
Thank you.
Okay.
Get out! I'm on a podcast!
I have a question.
What's your question? Ask your question.
Tijin Lee, what was the temperature today in Philly?
It's like 45. It's not bad.
It was awesome today.
It was.
I went outside and did things. Even though there was snow everywhere.
I wore a sweatshirt today.
I know, right? It was so nice. I wore a t-shirt.
I have actually a couple rounds here. Everyone shut the hell up! Fusion wants to talk! We have a couple of rounds of America's favorite new game. Nobod, Knucklehead, or neither.
Everyone clap.
So Nobod, Knucklehead, or neither. Are you going to rotate in who Knucklehead
is? You need to make like a dubstep intro to this game, just like they have Gavin or Google.
Okay, now.
All right, I'll do it.
We have 1, 2, 3.
I actually might have something.
We're gonna have 6 participants because the 7th and 8th cannot participate, which is myself and. Nobod. So I'm going to. If you don't know the rules, basically it's kind of like Gavin or Google, except it's better, about 1,000 times better.
Wait, I think this time we should go a little faster. So when you do the quotes, we should all just kind of give our answers in quick succession.
Yeah, for the love of God.
Okay. But remember, I'm going to call you off down the list. That way That way Ray doesn't have the opportunity to speak all over everyone like she's been doing tonight. So.
Yeah. She went on and on about that.
Welcome
cat.
To my life on the podcast, typically. Fuck you guys.
Okay.
That's normally me. Right?
Basically, here's the premise of the game.
my favorite character.
Via social media, there are 3 types of tweets or updates I have here from 3 different sources. Everyone's favorite musician, Nobod. A knucklehead, and this one is still Jaden Smith. Or neither, which are just generally random tweets from stupid people across our great lands of America.
There's a common theme.
I can still count as me, so...
Okay, so I'm going to read one off. I'm going to pick one from these 3, and each have to guess...
Oh, was Nobod on the last podcast we did this?
No, he was not.
Oh.
I was. That's
interesting. He can defend himself.
I'm really...
And so it's going to be... When I ask you, you either say it's either Nobod, Knucklehead, or neither.
Okay. Oh,
first one.
I'm not going to know the answers anyway. So
here we go. Seriously, this is an actual tweet from a human being. Does it take 18 months for twins to be born, or 9? Was that Nobod, Knucklehead, or neither? Chaos. What say you, Chaos?
Neither.
Okay.
I'm going to say neither.
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 I'm going to guess
totally neither.
What'd you say, Tijin Lee?
He's guessing Gavin.
Gavin?
I would say neither. Gavin.
Everyone got it right. It was neither.
Woohoo!
Okay. Here's another one.
I'm not that funny. Come
congratulations,
on,
Nobod.
Nobod, knucklehead, or neither. The more intelligent somebody becomes, the more I fall in love with them. Was that Nobod, knucklehead, or neither? Chaos?
Knucklehead?
Yeah, with a question mark?
I'll say knucklehead.
Tijin Lee.
Nobod.
Ray.
Nobod?
Also with low Zelda.
I'm going with Nobod.
Dark, what say that you?
Seems too poetic to be Nobod. I want to say him, but I'm going to go with knucklehead.
Does it really seem too poetic?
And the answer is Jaden Smith.
Are you kidding? Too poetic? Defense. I'm a rapper. What?
Yeah, that was too poetic for Jaden even. So.
Wait, no. You said you're not a rapper. You complained to me that people think you're a rapper and you're not a rapper.
He proposed the term rapper
earlier today.
It's true. I say random things. It's true.
Okay, now here's one. Nobod, knucklehead, or neither. This person quoted Tom Cruise, apparently. Wow, there are a lot of people with Bieber in their name. Someone should figure out how to turn Justin Bieber's backgrounds and names into energy. What? And they misspelled someone. Was that Nobod, what? Knucklehead, or neither?
The fuck?
Do you need me to read it again?
No, I'm just confused at the stupidity. So
wow, there are a lot of people. Okay.
I was so confused I drooled on myself.
Okay. You were doing that anyway, just so don't relate it to that.
Chaos, what say you?
I'm just throwing Nobod out. I don't think it's Nobod, but I'm just going to say it.
Okay, Nobod. Okay, Webway.
Apparently Nobod is so stupid that Ray drools on herself.
I'm going to say neither.
Okay, and Tijin Lee?
Neither.
Ray?
Neither.
Dark.
So we should decide, is it neither or neither?
I really want to say neither, but since I haven't,
it's neither.
Say neither.
I haven't gone for it's Nobod yet, I'm gonna say Nobod.
Okay, Lozelda, what say you?
I'm going with neither.
It's pronounced
the answer is neither.
Yay!
Actually,
I was gonna be really, really upset if it was Nobod. Like physically upset.
You would have started beating Nobod.
Yeah, she would have started physically ill, started vomiting on herself. Yeah.
One more, here we go. And I think this one's gonna be pretty easy.
Because, you know, Nobod hasn't been guessed
like the
yet.
Rest of us on here?
Hey!
What?
Speak for yourself. Speak for yourself.
I'm only easy after I've had too much to drink.
You said I haven't pulled one from Nobod yet, so this one could be Nobod, but
it's going
to really?
Be
Nobod. Really?
I don't think you should name the game Nobod, Knucklehead, or neither if Nobod's not featured at least once.
Well, hey, I have to throw you guys off.
I want to hear that. I'm only here to hear the stupid things that Nobod says.
Are you
now
on Facebook?
The truth comes out. You know, you can leave.
That's what I'm here for.
Just for that, Tijin Lee, I'm gonna probably pull one that's not his. So
okay. You can just listen to every podcast and you be good.
That's true.
Okay. Here's Nobod, knucklehead, or neither. When you're at home doing everything you can not to message that person first, even though you have everything to say because they are so easy to talk to, but want them to want to talk to you too.
That sounds like
my Nobod. Brain just died.
I think
chaos.
Nobod.
it sounds like
Nobod.
I'm gonna say
if he's trying to type fast.
Fuck. I'm gonna say Nobod.
That is true. That is the way
your
he
post
sounds
gave me cancer.
that tweet gave him cancer.
Enough cancer to kill you during this podcast?
Wow.
Just about.
That's Hitler level of cancer.
And now we're back to Hitler.
I'm going
to
say Nobod.
It always comes back to Hitler.
Ray, what say you, Ray?
Yeah, Nobod.
Tijin,
I love you.
Low Zelda.
If for the sake of keeping a little bit of faith, I'm going to go with knucklehead.
I'm going to go with neither.
The answer is No bod.
Hey, oh,
great place.
You are such a disappointment to me.
So at this point, perfect score, leading the way, Mr. Webwave.
Darn.
Fuck yeah.
Wasn't it last time too?
Wait, what was I wrong on? I don't remember.
You were off wrong on question number two. I didn't number them, so.
You were wrong on number two, but he didn't number them. So, you know, pretty much he just decided you were wrong at some point.
I created a little spreadsheet on who was right and wrong.
So how do you do a spreadsheet without numbers?
Well, no, the quotes are on a second sheet of paper. They're just
so you have two spreadsheets.
I have a whole this game.
Your story keeps changing, Mr. Fusion. I think you're lying.
The mechanics of this game. A spreadsheet about this game
that lets him find out the
mechanics to this game. It's insane.
Ray is breaking down over there. I think we need to be concerned.
What's wrong? With Ray?
She's really upset. She doesn't have a bagel.
Ray, are you okay? What's going on?
What about a bagel?
Like bagels.
Someone fetch her a straight jacket.
I wonder if I'm going to be this annoying when I'm drunk.
Cream cheese bagel, please.
Oh, wait, why are we talking about bagels? Because I really want one now.
Cream cheese bagel.
I didn't.
You like the little slices of fish they put on them?
Oh, yeah, bagels and lox, man. That's where it's fucking at.
How did you not number them in a frog at number two?
Oh, she's still hung up on that.
Okay. I have one printout over here with three columns of quotes. One column for Nobod, one column for Knucklehead, one column for neither.
Yeah, on no one really
on another sheet of paper, I created a list of names of everyone participating, and I check everyone off for each round. That's how I can tell what question you got wrong.
All that's important is that I won.
Did anyone really win this game?
That's
you know what? Fuck this. You all... All lose. Game over. You all lose. No, fuck you. Over.
Damn it, Ray. I pay him good money to win.
Bubs lost. So Zelda, you lost. Dark, you lost. Ray, we know you lost. Tijin Lee, all lose. You know who won? In all this?
I won
because I'm
I feel
awesome.
Like Nobod won because he only had one stupid thing to say.
Is this the first
time? Oh, no, I have several here. You want me to read them off?
Please.
Go for it. Let's read.
I want to hear what I said.
Save for games. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, there will be plenty more. Trust me.
Here's one from Nobod. All MMA fighters can box, but not all boxers are fit for the cage.
The fuck, dude.
Okay, I'm going to guess
it's
nothing.
True.
That's Nobod.
It's true.
Give us another one.
I laugh when people say they box and could kick my ass. I'm like, another cage... One bro. And that's exactly like that. Cage, bro.
Cage, bro.
You say that to them, like, hey, you want to fight? You're like, cage, bro. You're like, what the fuck?
Wait, hey, I can log into Facebook and pull some from the musings of Nobod right now.
Fudge!
I have so many better posts. Why do you choose those? Do I need to find you them?
We're finding your best posts.
Yeah, I can do this.
What's your best worst posts?
I'd buy these stamps now. My Little Pony stamps. Okay.
Dude, you can probably find really good shitty MLP related tweets, I have to say. That'd probably throw a lot of people off, just saying.
Whoever buys me the Ultimate Fighter Season 12 for my birthday on March 11th. Oh, happy birthday.
I saw that today.
Yeah.
Will forever be loved by me. I will literally be one of two people outside my family. He will literally be one of two people outside of his family.
Figuratively.
Literally be one of two. No, he's literally be one of two people outside of my family that have any little bit of love from me. Special. Okay.
What?
That
you
started
mean,
good
you
in
don't
that
have any love for me? I thought we were pals.
Yeah, we're family, though.
You and his voice.
I tried to do equals three. I did less than two.
Oh, my.
That was Ray, pretty bad.
Ray, you're drunk. You need to go home.
Yeah, Ray's drunk.
Oh, come on.
Ray's mother if you can hear me, bring her some water or she's going to have a massive hangover in the morning.
Ray, you smoked one too many alcohols.
This is unfair. Not enough.
This is unfair.
I don't think my medication.
I don't think Ray's mother is listening. There's no hope for her. Ray, I apologize in advance for the massive hangover you're going to experience tomorrow.
Never mind, Ray. You smoked one too many alcohols.
What?
What did she just say?
She's reading from the Skype chat. She has
I told Ray that Terry really wants to share her vodka.
Oh, okay. I didn't see the chat.
With Ray.
I didn't see the chat. I thought she really broke. I was
Ray is like in anticipation.
Oh, shit. That's not good. So, Luzelda, are you excited about RTX?
Why, yes, I'm very, very excited.
I am also very excited for this big festivities.
Ray, remember to breathe. Please,
you know,
breathe.
Had you asked me 6 months ago who would be probably the most likely to be banned from the podcast, I would not have picked Ray. I would say, why? She doesn't say anything.
I'm pretty sure Ray is.
This isn't the audience's favorite character. This is
Catbug. Is that who it is?
I think the better question is, if someone asked you who is most likely to be banned from the podcast, who would you have said?
Myself.
Dun, dun, dun.
I would have picked myself.
No, only Master Keg would ban you from the podcast, Mr. Fusion.
Yes, I know.
Yeah, he's trying to start a rivalry with you. It's hilarious.
I know, it's race wars. What can I say?
My money's on white. Man.
On this podcast.
Full racist.
Hitler level racist? You started murdering people in the last
genocide?
Couple minutes?
Yes, you're talking about.
Okay, maybe not that high.
People,
somewhere between like casual and like Hitler.
Guys, somewhere as far as Hitler goes, I just want to read a quote from Terry.
That is a pretty fucking big discrepancy there. Somewhere between casual and Hitler.
Is that the new rating scale thing?
Yes.
Could you imagine if that were a difficulty setting on a video game? You have
Hitler.
You have casual, then you have Hitler.
You have like cream puff, normal, difficult Hitler.
You're not wrong, though. Have you ever played, like, strategy games versus AI? You have, like, easy, where they, like, lay down and will just, like, let you stomp on them. And then they have normal, where they'll just bend you over and just go to town.
Is that Hitler level?
I don't know what games you're playing.
That's Hitler level.
Things David should do.
So he likes it's those weird Second Life games or something. I don't know.
It was in Japanese. I didn't see.
I logged into
see what they were saying,
once.
But, I mean, that's pretty awesome.
Did a Second Life once a couple years ago to see what it was like. That is some weird shit, man. It's disturbing.
I logged into it once too. I had to sake my curiosity. I created an account, logged in, walked around for a little bit, and I'm like, the hell is this? And then I logged out. Never logged back in again.
Did you run into anything weird or what happened?
There were people flying, there were people arguing about who owned what house, and I think I saw someone having sex with someone else, but
it's like half chat roulette on that game now. I mean, that's pretty much what it is.
Only these were like boning. Animated characters, and so I'm like, really? What sort of sexual satisfaction do you get out of watching your characters fuck? I mean, I'd much rather do it in real life than watch a character do it.
I would also like that, but not everyone gets a chance. Okay, just saying.
Did you ever hear about the Ralph Puton character? What? Oh my god! Okay, you know how some of these Second Life people, I don't know. I mean, Lo Zelda's really quiet, and so is Tijin Lee. You guys aren't Second Lifers, are you?
What the fuck is Second Life?
I have no idea what you're talking
about.
Second
Life is like,
an MMO version. It's an open world version of like The Sims.
Yeah.
You create a character.
Oh,
the
god,
problem is,
that sounds awful.
No,
it's basically like a 3D way to chat. It's like I just don't see the appeal.
But this is awful because it has its own micro economy, and people are like there are people who have made hundreds of thousands of dollars in real life funds by creating houses and then selling them.
But yeah, because the the prop, there's actual like land value. Yeah, people will buy and sell properties, and people will actually get married in Second Life.
There are people that they own businesses that are strictly based in Second Life. Like they have characters that create clothing and stuff, and you buy when you first spawn. There's people that purchase banners like advertising banners all over the place, and it's really weird.
It is really creepy. It's kind of like someone intentionally created the Matrix.
Yep.
And then they're like, "Yeah, we're creating the Matrix. Don't you want to be a part of it?" And that's what Second Life is.
You guys really should take a look at it. When you read into it, it's just kind of fucked up.
GFP, let's play.
Second Life. No, you don't really play Second Life. That's where Second Life plays you.
Yeah,
That's where it's kind of like The Sims, because you don't play the game. It's like you are kind of your character. So you just kind of walk around and talk with people, and then
if you're like one of those people that don't like to really talk with people, or you're not very fan of, I guess, just chat in general, it's not very many things you can do.
And well, there was a meme. Somebody created this character called Ralph Puton, and he would go. He was a short little green troll that walked around smoking and drinking a beer, and he would just fuck with people. Like if people were having virtual sex in the game, he would just show up and just start watching them. And he would people would say in the chats like, "Ralph, go away," and his simple reply was just no. And you really have to see it. It's just the screenshots will crack you up. It's this little short troll just smoking a cigar or a pipe, drinking a beer.
Like, I'm going to watch this boning happen, and I'm going to enjoy myself now.
Well, he would just pop up and stand there.
Wait, he doesn't like bother people or anything.
He just stands there.
But does he respond if people talk to him?
He'll usually say no, because they'll say go away, because he kind of finds the awkward conversations people are having. Like if they're talking about sex, he finds the weirdos. Like he'll go and find the people that are like cybering, and you know the whole game. I mean, you could just do pretty much anything in the game. He'll just stand there watching them the whole time, creepishly just looking at them.
No.
All right, who did we drop? Did anyone drop?
Bobweb dropped.
We lost Bobweb.
And we actually lost Ray a long time ago, but for different reasons.
Brown Bomber is going to the oven.
Uh-oh.
I told him he should go to the shower, brown guy, and he said only if you show me your oven afterwards.
Are you cybering in the...
Wait, did you just proposition him?
It was a Nazi joke, because a 999 come take a shower, brown guy. And he said only if you show me your oven afterwards.
And then you said he was going to the oven. So if the oven is you...
This girl, something else, man.
It turned into a Hitler thing. I'm sorry.
We finally know the real Ray. We know what Dark knows, or what Chaos knows.
Not Dark.
What's Dark?
What are you doing, Dark?
I have been found out. I'm sorry, Chaos. You had to find out eventually. Ray, should we tell him?
Yeah, Chaos. He's not really gay.
I've been pretending all this time just so...
I'm so like sorry. I told something I wasn't supposed to tell.
No, Tijin Lee's been Ken the whole time.
Shit. Guys, I'm Asian.
Truth.
Dear God, it all makes sense.
Truth is, Dark is like all about the trim, man. He's
just smaller than Tijin Lee.
Hey, that's being stereotypical, Ray. Shame on you.
So no kid is the opposite, then?
I said that was being stereotypical.
Poor Ken.
Wait, what did she say? I couldn't hear her. She
was really quiet. You're better off.
Closer to your mic. You're getting quieter.
I think that's a good thing.
She was making a penis joke.
David, you don't make it started on you, so let's keep going.
So, Lozelda,
Ray said you had a little dick, Chaos.
Yes, I can tell.
Wow. You know, you're not legally bonded to her yet. Just throwing it out there.
Can we just rename this podcast The Rest?
I'm just saying.
He won't leave. He loves me.
You still have the receipt and the receipt out the window.
Oh, that's a little harsh, Fusion. That's just a little harsh.
I meant the ring, but... Good recovery, right?
At the ring. Okay. Yeah. I bought this bullshit on my hand at Walmart for $11. He hasn't got me a real ring yet.
It's okay. He's young. He'll build his wealth, and then, you know.
I'm the one that's going to be working. He's going to be going to college. I have to bust my ass.
He has to pay you half when he divorces you. That's
okay. Well, I just walked back in on.
Oh, Wubwave's back.
Hey, what's up? Podcast, what's up?
Wubwave's back, and I got to go.
We haven't said anything for the last...
Why didn't you guys close the podcast
yet? No, if Wubwave ever drops... No, Wubwave, just imagine we're all just kind of sitting and staring at your icon until it comes back.
That's all we do. It's dead air. Except for Ray.
Wait.
Okay, Ray.
Racism.
Ray, Ray, can you just collect yourself for a minute so you can say bye to Nobot, okay?
So whenever Ray racist. Does an ism, it's called a racism.
Oh. That's just true. Might be it. That actually sounds like a really good meme we could start.
No, you know what? I have respect for you two because she loves you and she said yes.
That might be a new game.
With an $11 ring, that's mad respect. Right there. You don't even want to know how much I had to bleed out.
A quarter?
Can we guess? Can we guess?
Take a wild guess. Go ahead.
A quarter.
$1,200.
I'm gonna guess $1,400.
That's a good guess, but no.
309.
No, wait, Fusion. 1,401. Fusion. Here's my actual guess.
420.
513. No.
Darn.
316.
2000.
Austin, 316.
Chat. That would be kind of cool.
Whoever's in chat, you can guess too.
Yes, guess. Everyone guess in the chat.
Austin 316 says, how much did I just whoop your ass?
It'll take about, because of Twitch's like automatic lag, it'll take them like 30 seconds to hear what we just said. So give them a bit.
I'm just going to sit here silently and wait for the chat.
I should be leaving.
Nobot, then go ahead and leave. Nobot,
no, stay.
Goodbye, Nobot.
I know, I have to go.
Say goodbye to Nobot.
Nobot, switch out for your dead.
Ray, what? Ray, be nice and go tell Nobot bye-bye, okay?
Packing your dad in.
David, Nobot.
What?
Tagging for your dad.
What just happened?
What? Nobot is the new David.
I don't want to be David. David can't make music.
I was reading David is racist.
I haven't fried yet.
David is a racist.
What was that?
What?
I'm just making.
What was that?
That's him being a sarcastic asshole.
That's a really bad sarcastic laugh, and it was meant to be that bad.
Yeah. All right. Okay, now go away, Nobot. Bye.
I'm signing off now. Bye. Later.
And don't forget to give me your audio, goddammit.
I love you, Alex.
Don't call him Alex on the podcast.
Yeah, we're going to leave to the internet. Don't you know Ray?
Come on, Ray. Don't pull back that curtain. We have rules here.
Yeah.
God.
Rachel
Golden.
Well, apparently Fusion can't spell it right anyway. It doesn't matter if they know my name.
Raquel.
Well, I'm sorry you added an extra W in your name. I can't help it.
What
there was like a T and an I. She had a fucking tilde in it. I'm like, what is this?
A-E-L.
It's like, Rachel. It's Rachel.
All right, did anybody in the Twitch feed respond? It's been 30 seconds.
Here we go. We have 69, $5, 729, or 68.
Oh. People think you're cheap.
I like this. Your sister says, how about 68, and he owed her a dollar.
That's my sister.
Bad props, yo.
1 point for Ray's sister. Little Zelda's sister.
Names you, Dark.
I'm drunk as well, but not as drunk as you. So
I like how we went straight back to that sexist thing that happened on the last one, where all the girls sound the same and blah blah blah. No one can tell us apart. Apparently,
is that from your sister?
Who said that?
We said nothing.
Brown Bomber. Yeah. That happens on Brown Bomber. That happens on all podcasts. It took me forever
to tell
who was who on the internet box.
Brown Bomber doesn't know enough people from the podcast. He doesn't listen to it enough, so that's
You need to listen to more podcasts.
Oh, I'm not talking about them. I'm talking about the last, like last week on the podcast. Ray left and goes, "Okay, I'll be right back." And as soon as she cuts out, I don't remember who it was. I think it was TJ and Lee. Goes, "All right, well, now that Zelda's gone, we can talk about her." I'm like, "I'm still fucking here." What are you talking about?
Well, you should have called me out, and I would have felt really bad. And you could have shamed me.
I did call you out. We had a whole discussion about it last week. Fuck you guys.
I just listened to the podcast. I don't remember this conversation.
See, he thought he was having that conversation with Ray.
I don't remember this conversation, and I edited the podcast.
Good job editing there, buddy.
Maybe it wasn't.
I would have remembered if TJN. I think it might have been the one before that. I don't think TJN missed it on that one.
Yeah, Derek still calls me Nobot.
I would have felt really bad, and now I feel really bad.
Well, what way you and Nobot have a lot in common?
I'm going to tell you right now, I'm the easiest person in the world to make Shane because I feel bad instantly.
Aww.
I apologize a million times.
Everyone make fun of Tejan Lee now for being such a pussy.
You don't have enough material yet.
Wait, you're going to give us more material now?
You're going to get to know me.
Wonderful.
So can we have a segment called Getting to Know Tejan Lee?
Getting to know Tejan Lee. Tejan Lee 101. Tejan Lee, tell us about your childhood. What's your most embarrassing memory?
Read my journals. All of them.
What? No. Wait. No, first, we can have Fusion read one of your journals in a radio voice.
Tejan Lee strip.
That'll work.
Yes, Mr. Fusion.
We gotta get to know you.
Tejan Lee, what is your favorite pizza topping?
My favorite pizza topping is roast beef.
Ew.
Tejan Lee's favorite pizza topping is roast beef.
Now,
Wubwave, you're back. Good.
I was here the entire time.
No, the little thing was making that I lost you signal.
I lost you signal. It was lonely.
Wait, how did Dix get involved in this again?
You said the little thing, and I immediately thought Dick.
This is Drunk Ray. Everything's related to Dix and Hitler.
Barbara draws Dix.
I could be far worse. Thank you.
I can imagine inside Ray's imagination that she's picturing a Dick with the head of Hitler.
I never even pictured it. Dear God, don't start describing it.
Yep.
It's too late now.
She's picturing a Dick, only the head of the Dick is Hitler's face. And he's vomiting milk.
Whoa. What is this your sister is saying in the chat?
I have no idea. Not a clue.
I could share Zelda's embarrassing.
I don't even know which one she's talking about.
This is good. Oh, we need to read this. Come on, Mr. Vision.
And she will put you to the ground. Oh, it's okay.
And Sassy. I will put everyone on the server.
You're with friends, Sassy. You're with friends. Go ahead.
Text her. I want to know which one she's talking about.
To be fair to our listeners who cannot read what's going on, for their benefit, we have to read this out loud.
Do we really care about what those people know, though?
Not really, no. But yeah. I'm just trying to make an excuse to get this read out loud. Come on.
Oh my gosh, I can't get
this. Well, if I were you, Lozo, I'd probably just go ahead and tell your most embarrassing moment and get it out of the way because she's probably going to tell us. So, at least it'll be coming straight from you. So,
yes,
I would recommend you just go ahead and do that.
You can tell it in a better light.
Oh, whoa! Who is paying my sister with sexual favors? Fuck that! I don't.
Who? You can read the fucking
this
name.
A whole new
no, no! I'm going to tell you that right now. That was not our golden.
Oh, so it wasn't her. Okay.
Was it? Definitely not our gold. I'm just going to tell you that right now.
Definitely. Not
quite possibly. Red's hey, Chaos, you've reached the end of the world, by the way.
Yeah, that's like the second time I've hit a wall. It's like bribing with items. I just know I'm gonna find a diamond and it's gonna be like, haha, you can't have it. This is the edge of the world.
That drives me crazy.
And speaking of hitting walls, we have hit the 1 hour mark for this crazy excuse for a podcast.
No, we haven't. Sir.
I think we could go for another hour.
We're about 108. I say I can
find my house.
I think he just hates me. I think Fusion hates me.
Why do I hate you? Why?
I think you're annoying.
Okay. Well, if we're gonna keep going, just stop what you're doing right now so I can go pee, and then when I come back, I can know what we're talking about. So
left the middle of the podcast three different times.
It's okay, Dark. We will not talk about anything important. Go ahead. Feel free.
Oh, good. Okay.
Go ahead. Go. So anyway, this awesome story I'm going to tell you guys, you will not fucking believe it, okay? This will blow your mind.
I do actually tell the story and then like be wrapping up when he comes back.
I'm going to tell you about the time I got a stripper to take a dump on a cop car. On a serious note, I actually did bet a stripper to take a dump on a cop car. I'm not very proud of that.
I'm not very proud of that.
It's a very low point in my life.
Is this last week, wasn't it?
No, this was in college. these are the things that go on in college chaos. So, and if you don't,
you have much to look forward to.
Yes, you have much to look forward to. And if you never never get the opportunity to bet a stripper to take a dump on a cop's car, you did not fully experience college life.
And you will never fully experience
that
college
life. That needs to happen at least once.
Yeah, see that's college on campus life. I'm just going to kind of slowly close the door and scoot away from that.
Okay, so when Dart comes back, I'm going to act like I told a great story and everybody just go, wow, what the fuck?
Well, why can't you just tell us that story?
I have a question.
So if we're saying you haven't really, you know, you didn't really have the college experience if you didn't, you know, bet a stripper to take a dump on a cop car, what if you were the stripper?
Hypothetically. Oh, you missed it, Dark. It was an unbelievable story.
So we need to find this stripper and get her on the podcast. That could have been more perfect. Because this the other half of this story needs to be told.
I once got a stripper to take a dump on a cop car.
That's kind of dark amazing.
Oh my goodness.
I feel like my mind has been molested.
I'm sorry,
by that story.
We're asking a question in regards to college life. What was that?
No, no, it's all good. Never mind.
Okay.
In high school, during Truth or Dare, my first kiss was with a girl.
Really? Like, so was mine.
It's Truth or Dare, and I was like, okay, I have to see tomorrow again, but all right.
She kissed a girl.
As a side note, that story is true, but it's not exciting.
Wait, do people still play Truth or Dare?
A couple of years ago, they did.
Only when the power goes out.
Apparently. I mean, shit, you have the internet.
There was a power outage for you recently, Dark.
Yes. Oh, and even today at work, we didn't have a power outage, but the internet died. And it was like the apocalypse. Everyone was, first they freaked out, and then after about 10 minutes everyone just kind of sat there, pulled their phones out, and was like, well, this is the closest thing we have to the internet, so yeah, this is weird. Everyone just kind of wandered around like lost puppies for almost half an hour until the internet came back on. Like, no one knew what to do.
What do you do with your hands when there's no internet?
What happened if a customer tried to call you?
I set you up for that.
Masturbate. Oh, you don't have one.
That's too obvious, though.
Would it just put a never-ending wait tone if a customer had tried to call?
Oh no, we have a whole section of Filipino people.
Yeah,
and,
I was about to say the offshore level one. We can't transfer to level two right now, so please hold
right.
on.
They just have to hold for a while until the internet comes back on. It was weird because we had slight power fluctuations, like the lights dimmed for a couple of times, and we never lost the phone. And then suddenly, boop. Phone was gone, internet was gone, everything was gone. We're like, ooh, this.
I love that super excitement when the lights flicker. Everyone's like, oh my god! And then, oh wait, oh my god!
Was anyone like in the middle of a call?
Yeah, I was. mid call, I was helping someone adjust the text on one of their emails, and whoop, gone. I'm like, ooh, she's not gonna be happy. But that's what happens. I don't know. I don't even know if we figured out what caused it, like why we were having power fluctuations.
In the back, turning it off and on.
Looking like the breaker. He's just standing there eating a Twinkie. Like,
just sitting there laughing.
Also,
sorry for the podcast.
Oh, and this last time that when we had a bunch of power outages, I was joking around with a couple of guys at work. One of my coworkers, the last time the power went out at his house, he's like, "Okay, well, the power's out, so I guess I'm just gonna go do this." And then he realized, "Oh wait, that requires electricity." He's like, "Okay, I'm gonna go do this." "Oh wait, no, that requires internet, and the internet doesn't work because there's no power." He's like, "Okay, well, what if I do this?" And then that also required electricity.
Phones with unlimited data?
And he's like, okay, until my phone, when my phone dies, there's going to be absolutely nothing for me to do. Has anybody else had that where when the power goes out, you're like, okay, I'm going to go do this, and then you realize when you start to do that it requires an internet connection?
Sadly,
and you don't have
not watching happened. Porn? I'm not lucky. No, I don't know if I could call it lucky, but that's never happened.
Back in the day, you used to just go in the woods to find your porn, but now you have to use
forest porn.
The closest that happened to me actually was when there was a tornado, like, almost gonna form outside the house.
And you couldn't watch power
it. So out. You almost lost the internet once.
Yeah. No. The power did go out then, but that's the only time it happened. And that was like.
Guys, I almost lost the internet
I've
one
never
time.
Had a power outage.
Yeah, I've had that situation.
We don't have those
where...
in the East Coast tornadoes.
Yeah.
Night Song says thing. Michael Bay was shooting the fourth Transformers movie down the street. That's what
Wub's gone.
Yep, he's gone again. Bye, Wubs. Nice knowing you.
Bye, Wub.
So this one particular time, I had a particularly stupid moment when the electricity went out, and I thought, hey, okay, the power's out. That's not such a bad deal. I'll just go and play SimCity for a while. And then I sat down on the chair, and then I realized, I need power for this.
Do you guys have the UPSs at all?
UPSs.
Your backup batteries.
It's like a backup battery for computers. So if a power outage happens, you won't lose your data, and you have a chance to save and back up everything.
Yes, we've got that. But if the internet goes out, then there's no, you know, it doesn't matter that the power's still on. The internet's gone.
Wait, not if you have power going into the modem. If you plug the modem into the battery,
single player, or you have to be online to play that one.
Huh? What are we talking about? What game?
Remember, like Sims, you needed to be online for that.
No, SimCity, you have to be online, not the Sims.
Oh, okay.
Not for much longer, right?
Not for much longer. No, offline is coming.
We, you know,
does
I
that have to be an announcement.
I'm back, by the way.
You're yes, back.
You yes, welcome
That's
back.
Gonna
again.
Really good That's going to sound really good on the recording, because you were telling me a story about the internet and the power, and I'm like, oh, I have a journal about that recently, and I guess I didn't come through, and you're like, so does anyone have an experience like that?
Oh, man. I have to find your audio
story,
and mute it.
I lost power.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's go back in time. So does anybody have a story about that, Wubwave?
I made a journal about that recently, just in fact. It was a couple of weeks ago.
That's your story? Really? I made a journal about that? You know what? You're
that
fired.
That was a great story.
To get your
tell
finished journals, buddy.
No,
yeah, go
you
read
tell
that
the
journal.
Story that you told in your journal. That's what we're prompting you to do.
That was poison stuff right there.
You failed. You just failed human interaction just now, just so you know.
That sounds like my life.
That does sound like
except right now.
Oh, did you guys see the question in the chat? How much of the internet would disappear if there was no more?
Oh. Too much of the internet would disappear if there was no porn.
If you say like the weight of the internet is like 1 million pounds, like how much do you think weight wise the internet would lose if porn
was 999,000 pounds?
Yes, I agree.
I think porn has that much influence over the internet.
Yes, at least 900,000 pounds.
I think 69%. Nice. Whatever from the 20s might have like a little page on it, but I really want to know what the like official or estimated weight.
Did anybody not see that video?
Have you ever looked at porn, David? Like not just Googling.
Yeah, David. Have you
even
looked at porn?
Yeah, David.
No, I have not.
Well,
what?
I did.
He's never gonna admit to that.
So you don't even know what your favorite type of porn is? You are so sheltered,
dude. Just say, yeah, I've never watched it. Just say it like that.
Plausible deniability, buddy.
Yes, exactly.
But I didn't.
There is nothing plausible about that deniability.
Why can't he admit it? I did.
Ray, what is your favorite type of porn?
No. I'm not gonna admit that. Well, but then I watched it.
Ray, I will tell you what my favorite type of porn is if you tell me what your favorite type of porn is.
No, after the podcast, maybe.
I'll
accidentally forgot to turn the stream off.
Wow, you don't get to know either.
Wedding off.
Wedding night's gonna suck for you. Actually, no, it's not gonna suck.
Yeah, you're gonna learn some crazy shit.
She was making a joke of how you're not going to get fellatio.
No,
from.
I got that one. I'm not completely oblivious.
He's not used to vagina yet.
You know, because dick, mouth.
No. I just don't have quite the direct gutter mind, but it's not like I don't understand a lot of the references. I just don't jump to that instantly.
You've experienced a lot of the references. You just haven't been inside a vagina.
you know, it's no. The problem is he's that's just good. Not desensitized to that level of debauchery like we have debauchery? All become.
Debauchery.
Yeah.
Debauchery.
We've developed a debauchery callus.
Dave, I've never looked at porn either, dude. You're not alone.
I call bullshit.
You guys are so full of shit. Come on.
I call bullshit. It depends on what
I never have safe search on Google images, so I'm pretty.
Yeah, that's true, Dave. It depends on what your
definition of is.
Yeah, I know he's Googled shit to look at.
He's Googled.
Google. I like that accent that came out. Just,
what was that?
He's Google.
I've gone to straight porn, but I know he just Googles like pictures. As far as I know,
he's just like, "What is porn?" He looks up porn. Spells it wrong. Spells it prawn. Ah, that's
how I spell it. How do vagina penis insert?
Well, that's the other side of the internet. There's porn and there's prawn. Prawn is everything else.
Has anybody heard of Booble?
Booble.
Is a search engine for porn.
Really?
Yes.
So there's a link in Google. No, I'm kidding.
Isn't that just Google though? I mean, do you really need a separate search engine?
This website probably filters out everything else, so you wouldn't
except
have,
for porn.
Yeah, you wouldn't have to
everything
worry that
else. It's nothing but porn.
It's like find the 1% of the internet that's not porn is filtered out with Google. I'm gonna mute the mic while he starts masturbating to whatever.
He's gonna play Fappy Bird in the background.
Who? Oh yeah.
You don't even want to know what my high score is, buddy.
I do want to know now.
9 times. That's the high score.
You have that record, dude.
Score you've seen someone
carpal have. Tunnel, man. Carpal.
Yeah, the best I ever did was 7 times a day.
In that game, you just shake the phone.
Yeah, he's right.
Instead
actually.
Of swipe it or tap it. Yep. God, somebody's got to make this.
Well, there is a Fabby Bird game already.
Is there? I googled it at work and it didn't.
We talked about this last week.
Yeah,
you have to use Booble.
No, that was
because
David didn't say it right.
No, it's not that I didn't say it right. It's that's every time I saw that word, I just couldn't help of seeing it without.
Of course, of course you couldn't, David.
Fapping bird.
Well, you don't have to fap much longer. Don't worry.
Then you're gonna be married and you'll have to fap. That's all you have, right, Fusion?
Yep. Wait, what? What's that?
Because married life is.
What?
I was doing some.
That's
research.
The joke, but you guys fucking.
You're doing some cough research.
Cough. I was doing some research.
I was playing some mobile gaming.
Yeah, I'm playing threes. Yeah. What was the question, Webb?
Nothing. The joke's ruined.
Oh,
he was saying that since you're married, you don't have sex anymore, and you have to just use your best friend is Rosie Palmer.
Oh. Well, I wouldn't say I'm not having sex, Toms.
No, I'm saying that's what Whoopwipe was saying, not me. Yeah, that didn't come from... Okay.
I think that came from Dark Mind.
That's the long-standing joke, yes. I can neither confirm nor deny.
When you're married, you
don't
have
sex. David, I've waited long enough.
What the fuck was that noise?
That was a sarcastic...
That was Fappy Bird.
I was happy.
No, it was the noise chaos made.
Yeah, it was happy bird.
Yeah, is that the sound of the victory noise.
Out of all the noises, I imagined Fappy Bird to make. That's not one of them.
Obviously, you've just not been doing it right.
Itzel says he's lost faith in humanity again.
Well, it's your fault for starting it again.
Yeah, why did you regain it?
Well, there's one stray moment where you might have a little inch of faith from the few.
No, dude, when you're having those moments, you go to People of Walmart,
and then you realize there is no hope for humanity.
Yeah, there's no reason for me to have hope again. No, all is lost.
I've gazed the Walmart machines around. The abyss has gazed back.
Of Walmart? Yeah, it's
of Walmart. Yeah.
Lozelda, do you shop at Walmart?
I've
ever gone to like Dollar Store.
I love Walmart. Fuck you guys.
What? That doesn't surprise me.
I didn't say anything bad about it. I just said I don't shop there. Calm the fuck down.
I asked you a simple question.
Are you good for Walmart?
Calm your tits,
why are you so Walmart defensive?
Well, Lozelda, I don't shop at Walmart either.
Oh, good. Thank you. I'm not alone.
No. God, Dark. Jesus.
You don't want to save whatever their motto is for money?
No. No. I rather despise Walmart. I got my ring at Walmart, David. For.
You shut the fuck up.
Ooh, I was.
She just I put you in kind of against place, son. Dark in
that case. This podcast is brought to you by Target.
I didn't even like Target.
I would
really
love a sponsor. I don't really care. That would be so hilarious to have like a little thing to read.
Ron Jeremy's the sponsor.
Oh, by the way, anyone watching the stream, there's a Tower of Pimps with a waterfall coming out of it periodically over there.
Who built
that? That other dick joke?
Go for it.
It sounds like
whip it out, buddy. Go for it.
Wait, how old are you? No, don't do it.
Don't do that.
Wait, everyone here is a
base. Someone wants us to connect Walmart with Hitler. Let's get on that in the Twitch chat. So well, what Walmart, point does this conversation go full circle and connect Walmart to Hitler?
Is there Walmart?
They also serve 6 million.
It all goes full circle.
No, how widespread is Walmart? Like, is it in other countries?
It's trying to invade
it's in every
countries.
Ghetto in America.
Well, I know that. I was just wondering.
So, Ray, those are not other countries.
It's Ray. Be
might as well be.
Again.
Have you talked to those people? I don't think they speak English.
Hey, I live in the ghetto.
You live in the ghetto?
In the ghetto.
Didn't you have an experience with the Chola recently?
I do live in the ghetto.
Mr. Wartburg, I'm 22 going on 23, so shut up. Don't stay old.
That's pretty old.
Wait, who's old? Why are we talking about people
like,
being old now?
Mr. Wartburg. That you talk about what he used to do, and it's like there was still the black and white.
Blood. Well, he was there around during World War II, old-timey radio, so.
Yeah.
I was. True story.
I like how 35 is considered super old on this podcast.
Especially since most of your heroes on Rooster Teeth are in their 40s.
Dude, they're old, too.
Yeah, they're just like pillars of history.
Wasn't it just like the big three? Like, most of the lads are like 20-ish.
Well, yeah, the big three, they have some new people that are pushing. Let's see.
Oh, no, they've got a ton of behind-the-scenes guys. They're established. They're old. They have experience. Mm-hmm. You know, they're just not.
And they wanted to bring in some man meat to offset all the girls, so they brought in Blaine.
Oh, God, Blaine. Best hire they've ever made.
Well, we know who Love Zelda's favorite staffer is.
I am so not ashamed to admit that.
Did you already send Barbara the email that you want to be his PA for RTX?
Ooh.
I've definitely made it known that I would be okay being a PA if I happen to be Blaine's. I'm not exactly going to be upset about it, although my husband might have a jealous thing going on.
I would volunteer, too, and I'm not a guardian.
I would leave David for Blaine, I swear to God.
Oh, really? You roll that way too, Tijan? I did not know that. Good for you.
Oh, shit, that's on recording.
Yeah.
Wait,
that's
what?
Permanent.
It's official now.
That's it's on the internet. That shit's permanent.
That better start sucking dick, Tijan Lee.
if you need less. Since you know
what's
who to
like
call.
Danica
well, you guys already know I'm Ken, so it's okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You have
I'm
been
so
Ken
confused
this whole time.
That I met Ken last year.
No, Ken is doing like it's one of those things where you can kind of put on a different voice. He does that this entire time when he's on the podcast so that you don't recognize him when he's in person.
Not at all. Yeah.
Suddenly it all makes sense.
I mean, you've
it's
never
to you,
see, here's a big point. Have you ever seen them in the same place?
Womp womp womp.
I've been on Rooster.com the whole time.
What doctor did we decide T. Janley was? The 53rd, the 79th, what?
The gynecologist.
I don't know.
I'm the 14th.
Yes.
14th?
He's the 14th.
Ken is the Ray, that was ridiculous.
In the next 10 podcasts, the 14th doctor will be announced.
You know, that's why he was saying it was podcast 55, because he's the 14th doctor, and
I'm
by
not
the
that
time the 55th podcast comes out, he will have been on the show.
Yes.
I'm just saying, Ken is the 15th.
Hey, Lizelda, how bad is a gynecologist? I've never been.
I do not feel like I have had enough to drink to have that conversation on a podcast.
I'm going next Tuesday. Help a girl
tell you what. You and I can have a conversation not on the
podcasting
internet.
That's a private Skype call right there.
But. No, it's not.
It could be. This is an opportunity for a very educational experience. I think we should explore this.
Fusion, put on some educational music right now in the background.
There will be
Fusion. Have you gotten your prostate examined yet?
No.
What's that like?
I have like 5 years, so they stick their fingers up my butthole, dude. So I'm good.
Really, you have to be that old?
Yeah, it's older than that. Actually, it's like 10 years because
yeah,
45 now.
My doctor does it all the time. That's weird.
Yeah, my grandfather you look for a new doctor, dude. I'm just telling you now.
That's a joke. Yeah,
I'm a doctor.
No, it was a good joke. It was. I give it a B.
Are you sure? I mean, I just felt sort of.
No, no. When I edited the podcast, I'll even throw a rim shot underneath your joke when you were done. When you
said, "Oh, really? That'd be great."
Yeah, but be great. It'll be perfect.
I mean, just sometimes, you know, I just sort of feel like the forced.
No, it's not forced.
No?
No.
Oh, okay.
No,
cool.
Not at all.
It's not forced if she can't say no.
See, and there comes the rape. I knew that was coming.
No.
That's a rape.
Ray, the correct saying is, it's not rape as long as you yell surprise. That's the proper way to do it.
Okay, so on the rape checklist, we have Hitler, rape.
What else did she?
Seriously, what's the Ray scorecard for tonight, folks? We have Hitler, we have rape.
Awful times awful times awful.
Okay. Oh, it's awful. Too many.
She's bringing up the gyno.
I didn't say I would not appreciate it.
Making wedding night references.
Like you guys don't think about it. Whenever we mention wedding, the first thought I'm sure Dark has is that he's going to get fucked.
The race scorecard.
I'd like to weigh in here with the whole wedding night thing. Is what's going to happen is you're going to say that, and then the wedding's going to get there, and by the time it gets to the end of the night, you're going to be like, I'm fucking exhausted, and you will just fall over into bed in your dress and go, we'll fucking do it tomorrow. I'm going to sleep. I'll see you tomorrow. Wait. It'll be great.
And I'm going to go ahead and pull back the curtain, so to speak.
And now we know how Low Zelda's honeymoon went.
No, the honeymoon was much, much later. We got married in June, and we waited till it got cold and nasty and ridiculous in Michigan.
Smart.
And then we went to Mexico while it was like fucking 5 feet of snow here. It was fucking brilliant.
Chaos. Brilliant. Chaos. I approve.
Chaos Low Zelda is correct in that the bride will be too exhausted. But there's one thing you get to look forward to. She will be too exhausted, and she won't know what's going on. So.
And now we know how your wedding night is.
Could be out cold.
He's gonna stick in the wrong place. He doesn't know what to do.
We're not gonna instruct him.
We'll set up diagrams.
Leave an iPad with the video.
He'll figure it out. That's the point of it.
All right.
Diagram. Have a 2-hour class beforehand.
We'll draw. No, 2 hours. He doesn't need 2 hours. It's like 2 minutes. It's like, here's a picture. That's what you're going for. Have fun, and then you close the door.
Yep, I agree with you, Low Zelda. And if that doesn't work, then there's no hope.
Pain, exactly.
I have some videos I can show him. He'll figure it out.
Your videos are probably going to be scarring.
You're not wrong. I have a secret folder in my porn folder.
Wait, I
have a secret folder?
Just watch it online. Why do you save it?
So you have a secret folder in your folder.
A secret folder
for the most dire circumstances.
No. It's a secret folder because then you can be like, oh, this is my folder, ha ha ha. But then it's like the dark side and full of all.
That is exactly what it is.
It's a folder so secret that in case someone stumbles across it.
Yeah, you need like two keys to turn, like when you launch a nuclear missile.
Who has the second key?
Are you calling your dick a nuclear missile?
She's just on fire tonight, folks. Wow.
Yeah, she's on something.
How many drinks have you had, Ray?
A few. And I don't drink, so,
Oh, that explains a lot.
The Klonopin doesn't help. He told me, my doctor said don't drink, and I think I understand why.
By all means, let's not listen to our doctor.
No, it's okay. She checked with me earlier, and I'm the chemist.
Yeah,
so.
She's fine.
It's all good. I didn't say it was fine. I just said you're not going to give yourself liver damage, and that's what the concern was.
Oh, she's giving yourself liver damage.
Yeah, that's
all recorded.
Okay, that makes me feel better, because you said chemist. For some reason, I thought you were a geologist. I'm like, what are you doing giving her advice?
Where the fuck did you get geologist from?
I don't know. I don't know. It's not my head.
Science, you know, it's all the same.
I don't
Bill
know.
Nye, the science guy.
Fucking science.
Bill Nye.
My mom texted me. Ask everyone to vote on whether I give you more alcohol or not.
I think she's done, Mom.
Yeah, Mom, she's done. Cut her off, take her home, put her in a straight jacket, and don't let her near anything except water.
Be sure you roll her on her stomach, Mom.
It's about time we got on first name basis with Mom, so.
What is Mom's name?
Elizabeth.
Hi, Liz.
Hi, Elizabeth. Ray's mom.
Liz, it's been great talking with your daughter. She's
roll her on her belly tonight so she
very
doesn't
fun
choke on her own vomit.
Lizzie, we appreciate you being playing the role of bartender for
Ray.
Can
we call you Lizzie?
Can we call
you? We
next
appreciate
time,
it.
I feel like we know
water
each other.
Down the drinks.
He means make it stronger.
Yeah. Because we really want that, right?
No. Okay, guys.
Also pass
we
out,
have,
you know.
We've gone on for over an hour and 30 minutes now. I think it's time
so?
We wrap.
Yeah,
cuz we're fucking
we were just about
awesome
to get Liz on the podcast.
Yeah, seriously, you fucked it up.
No, Dark, but we can't end the podcast until Ken leans over to say like one word and
yeah,
cut it off.
We don't quit until Ken gets on.
Where's Ken?
He's in the other room.
Guys, I've been here the whole time.
He's in the other room. Call him in.
Guys, I really have to take a piss. Can we wrap this up?
I know,
just go. We'll still be here.
My bladder is screaming.
Why am I the only one that
knows? Oh, new game. We're going to stay on until either Lozelda or Ray has to pee himself.
First person to pee their pants.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay, it'll be a while. I had a glass of water, wine, a shot, and some screwdriver thingy my mom made me.
I have to pee so bad I'm physically in pain.
It kind of hurts, yeah.
Well, find a bowl.
You should always wrap up,
nearby.
You should have to ask that.
What's that?
You wrap up. You should always wrap up, Fusion.
Okay.
Married.
Out of respect for our lady folk who have to pee and who have the dignity to not run to the bathroom like I did earlier.
Let's not just call out the lady folk. Let's just say
No, we're calling out the lady folk. We're being
it's
sexist.
It's cuz the lady
here
folk are awesome. It's fine.
Now, Wubwave has to tinkle too. It's okay.
Like I said, lady folk.
No, I'm good. I'm sitting on the toilet now anyway.
Wow, you're silent.
We all know.
That is a really good wireless headset then.
Yeah, but you know,
is it like a push to talk feature or something?
I just have my laptop on my lap, you know.
So your laptop is just blocking all the sound. Then okay. So anyway, thank you all for joining us for this podcast tonight. Even though most of it sounded probably like an episode of The View less shrill voice.
I feel offended.
It was a bit.
Most of that is Ray's fault. Who just
if the View
there
sounded like
you
this, I think more people would watch
it. I should be like this, like I was last week. I might have gone a little too far.
It was a bit Viewish.
Nah.
So,
I think this is probably one
so
of
how many
the
how many episodes of The View have you seen?
One.
Yeah.
Enough.
Apparently, one was enough.
I stopped.
Knowing
there
it exists is enough.
I knew it was a horrible idea after I saw that one episode. I'm like, the fuck did I just watch? So anyway, thank you all who joined us on Twitch Live, and thank you all who will be listening to this podcast later. We will be doing this same time next week. Catch
same
you later.
Place.
Same place, same time. More beer, less Hitler.
You already made no, Dark. You already made that promise this time, and you failed on your promise for it to be
cheap.
I didn't
make promises
fail
you can actually keep. They're logical.
Ray failed because she's got the
nine.
Little
999.
But we can at least promise the more beer part. That I'm sure
more
we
beer
can handle.
There'll be more vodka. Beer. I promise. I won't run out.